Thank you. Good evening, and welcome to tonight's service of evening prayer. My name is Pastor Kate, and it's my joy to be here with you tonight. I'd like to take a moment to thank our guest organist, Dr. Marilyn Kaiser, for being with us tonight, as well as our student sacristy team, whose names are not in the bulletin. They are Carolina Bowen, Derek Minnick, and Matthew Yee. Thank you to our ushers for volunteering your time, and especially to our choirs and directors for offering your gifts to create holy beauty for our worship service tonight. Our service will be mostly led out of the red hymnals that you'll find around you, and this worship folder that you have will be your guide through the book. So to clarify what's going on, if in the paper you see a red number that says ELW, those are hymn numbers, so they're the very large numbers at the top of the pages of your hymnals. So they're the exciting ones. If they're red, they're the exciting big ones. If it's just regular black print with the little P meaning pages before it, that's regular page numbers. They'll be on the bottom page of your booklet. So red numbers, the big exciting numbers, black numbers, the little numbers on the bottom of the page. Those little numbers will all be within like 5 pages of each other, so if you want to stick a bookmark in there or hold your place, I highly recommend that. Finally, tonight happens to coincide with an ice cream fundraiser. So at about 8:30, students from our social action leadership team will be here in this building selling ice cream to raise funds for their annual World Relief Campaign. This year, the funds are going to a local nonprofit started by a Valpo alumna, and their goal is to help folks who are incarcerated transition back into life on the outside. So if you're interested in some ice cream and maybe helping out a good cause, please stick around after worship for that treat. With that, our worship continues.
Thank you.
A reading from Isaiah. Instead of bronze, I will bring gold. Instead of iron, I will bring silver. Instead of wood, bronze. Instead of stones, iron. I will appoint peace as your overseer and righteousness as your taskmaster. Violence shall no more be heard in your land, devastation or destruction within your borders. You shall call your walls salvation and your gates praise. The sun shall no longer be your light by day, nor for brightness shall the moon give light to you by night. But the Lord will be your everlasting light, and your God will be your glory. Your sun shall no more go down, or your moon withdraw itself. For the Lord will be your everlasting light, and your days of mourning shall be ended. Your people shall all be righteous. They shall possess the land forever. They are the shoot that I planted, the work of my hands, so that I might be glorified. The least of them shall become a clan, and the smallest one a mighty nation. I am the Lord. In its time, I will accomplish it quickly. O Lord, have mercy on us. A reading from the Gospel of Matthew. As Jesus went on from there, two blind men followed him, crying loudly, "Have mercy on us, Son of David." When he entered the house, the blind men came to him, and Jesus said to them, "Do you believe that I am able to do this?" They said to him, "Yes, Lord." Then he touched their eyes and said, "According to your faith, let it be done to you." And their eyes were opened. Then Jesus sternly ordered them, "See that no one knows of this." But they went away and spread the news about him throughout the district. After they had gone away, a demoniac who was mute was brought to him. And when the demon had been cast out, the one who had been mute spoke. And the crowds were amazed and said, "Never has anything like this been seen in Israel." But the Pharisees said, "By the ruler of the demons, he casts out the demons." Then Jesus went about all the cities and villages, teaching in their synagogues and proclaiming the good news of the kingdom and curing every disease and every sickness. When he saw the crowds, he had compassion for them because they were harassed and helpless, like sheep without a shepherd. Then he said to his disciples, "The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore, ask the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest." O Lord, have mercy on us.